how, though, could this potentially not go Cousins' way?
Well, I think it'll ultimately go Cousins' way. I think he'll get a record-breaking deal, and I think it'll probably be not just the leapfrogging that you refer to. The idea for Cousins is to set a new standard. But I think it's going to take some work getting there. And the reason is, I'm not sure the teams that can afford to blow out the budget for him are the teams he most wants to play for. So hypothetically, like, where are the teams you can go win right away that need a quarterback? Minnesota. They're going to need to, you know, keep some cap space and reserve for some of the defensive contracts they have to do the next couple of years. Jacksonville, they may be on the hook for $19 million for Blake Bortles for 2018. Those might be the two most appealing options. And when you look at the flip side, a team like a Cleveland Browns can spend whatever they want to get him, but maybe that's not a place you want to go. They just went 1-31 the last 2 years. So I think there are some things to sort out. I think it's about a month away from sorting itself out. I think once you get through the combine and get closer to free agency, we'll have a little bit better idea of Cousins' market, what's realistic, where he wants to go, what exactly he wants. But ultimately, I think we get to a point where he, as a healthy starting quarterback, unrestricted free agent with multiple teams allowed to bid, not someone doing a contract extension with their current team,
sure,
has a chance to go, you know, you see it going 25, 26, 27. Cousins could get to 30-plus if things work out the right way for him, if he finds the right fit with a team that has that money.
Especially with how it's worked out with the Redskins the last 2 years on a franchise tag. It's been one of the better soap operas in the NFL.